Hi everyone, welcome back to this first video of this course that is of open source intelligence. Okay, now that is basically a kind of introduction video about what is open source intelligence and what actually you are going to cover up, you know, throughout this course. Okay, so now this course is specifically based upon, you know, open source intelligence. That is, you know, the basic process of, you know, or one of the key skill sets, you know, if you're into investigations, if you're into cybersecurity, it doesn't matter if you're into forensics or threat intelligence, you should have that skill set. That is mandatory if you're into cybersecurity. If you're into investigations, then it can be a beneficial key skill to you. Okay. So now I'm your instructor, Lakshit Verma, for this. Okay. I'm a kind of cybercrime investigator, come OSINT analyst for some kind of law enforcement. Okay. I basically consult law enforcement agencies. So here's my LinkedIn profile. So that, you know, what I do is basically I consult, you know, or I consult, I give my services to Indian government and some kind of international governments as well and corporates as well. So as an investigator, as a cyber investigator, as a TFF dark web researcher, I consult them with my key skill sets, okay, with the help of, you know, like website intelligence, social media intelligence, human intelligence, geo intelligence, TFF OSINT and dark web OSINT. And like, you know, kind of threat actor profiling, some kind of fact checking kind of things. And that's a complete profile. So here is my LinkedIn, as you can see. So I you know, I have all kind of these, you know, skill sets, like, you know, related to website, related to social media, the DFAP and dark web kind of thing, complete OSINT kind of thing. So yes, that's a brief about myself. And yes, so I'll be your instructor throughout this course. And I'll be, you know, just guiding you guys, all of you, for how you can get started into open source intelligence. Okay. So this is the course that is entitled and, you know, will be managed by the platform that is Hakin9. Okay. Secondly, now this course, this complete course is designed in somewhat technique that you will, that will step up your game. Okay. That will step your, you know, that will give you a kind of add on to your investigative journey or something like that. Okay. Or it can be your cybersecurity journey as well. So if you are a cybersecurity guy, if you are an investigator, if you are an open source investigator, if you are a cybercrime investigator, this tool or this complete course will help you definitely to step up your game into cybersecurity. Okay, so if you are interested into, like, you know, building some kind of better understanding of open source intelligence and, you know, open source techniques, you know, if you want to enhance your kind of investigation skill set, okay, or if you want to go on and complete overall research methodology of reconnaissance, or if you want to, you know, improve kind of personal operational security, like OPSEC kind of thing, okay, so then you can go for it. Now the next thing is, see, if you are, doesn't matter if you are into a red teaming side and blue teaming side. For those who don't know what is a red teaming and blue teaming, let me just simplify that thing in a simple layman language. That in cybersecurity, the complete cyber world is divided into two parts only. The first one is the red team and the second one is the blue team. So red team basically includes all kind of possible attacking domains, okay, and the blue teaming basically includes all kind of defending, or, you know, like your security defending kind of all the domains, whether it is forensics, security operations, threat actors, threat actor profiling, and like that. And into the red teaming, we include everything like social engineering, hacking, you know, that kind of thing. So like PowerShell scripting and everything. Okay. So yes, this was it. So now doesn't matter if you're into red team or blue team, OSINT can be a key skill set for you. Okay. And this course is specifically for the people who are into actually open source intelligence and collection analysis and link analysis. So yes, this tool will help you. This course will help you. Whatever the tools, technologies, and procedures we have used, this will help you for sure. And these are the updated version kind of thing and currently working kind of tools. So yes, this can be an add-on to your cybersecurity research journey, your fraud or cyber investigator journey, or anyone who is interested in improving his skill set. Okay, then coming back to the next question, that can be why now, like why you should go for this course is basically, this course, and as I told you, there are two parts actually. See, OSINT is a kind of skill set that you will require for sure if you are stepping up into the cybersecurity journey now. Okay, so that is an in-demand kind of thing. Whether you are in security operation centers, if you are into forensics, if you are into threat intelligence, or any of the cybersecurity blue teaming or red teaming domain, OSINT is a kind of skill set. Okay, it just matters, you know, from what perspective you are thinking it of. Okay. Secondly, now because as cybersecurity is booming, so you should get familiar with these kind of skill sets, and this will help you for sure. Doesn't matter if you are an investigator, fraud investigator, a general cybersecurity guy, a blue teamer or red teamer, this will help you for sure. So yes, this course is the ultimate solution. for understanding the ultimate, tools that are working now, the data and the graph visualization kind of things for the DFF and dark web recon, and the complete open source interviews. In this course, we'll be, discussing about the tools like, Multigo. We'll be going through the Shodan search engine. Then we have, ReconNG framework, Spiderfoot. We have I been pwn.com, HTT track, Hunter.io, Sherlock, Profiler, GHunt, and some kind of inbuilt as well as pre-installed tools that comes up with Kali Linux, just like the Harvester, Burp Suite, like that. Okay, so these are the things and the skill sets that you will be learning up after completing up with this course is some kind of OSINT tools and their methodologies. Okay, some kind of social media intelligence related stuffs like how you can extract and find information from platforms and social media accounts like from different platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, like that. Okay, you will be able to gather information about the website using those in tools and techniques. Okay, that will help you to build up your website intelligence skill sets. Moving to the next, for phishing link analysis kind of thing, it will help you definitely. Okay, secondly, some kind of corporate profilings that you can help you into business intelligence or into bug hunting or VAPT kind of thing. And at last, the most crucial skill, that is OSINT report writing. So that will help you definitely. Okay. So yes, that was it. And yes, that's the complete scope. You will be learning about the OSINT, complete research, the complete tools, the complete techniques. And yes, that is all about. So this course is of total somewhat 10 hours. Okay. So now the next thing is there will be CPE points. Okay. There will be, you will get a certification after this completion of course. This is self-paced and pre-recorded course. And yes, it starts on the October 6th. Okay. So yes, this is all about it. And here are the details. I'm the instructor. This contains four modules. Okay. The first one is introduction module. Like that is a module zero. Then we have the module one. Okay. And then we have module two. That is people OSINT. Then we have social media OSINT and website and company OSINT. Okay. So a kind of mixed bunch is there of website, like website intelligence is there. Social media intelligence is there. Then, a business intelligence or revenue intelligence is there. Then there are some kind of tools that we have discussed. Okay. Some kind of proprietary tools we have discussed, some kind of commercial tools, some kind of free tools, some kind of open source tools we have discussed. So yes, this tool will definitely help you. This course will definitely help you. Okay. Apart from this, we have discussed some kind of techniques that will help you definitely for understanding this OSINT course and the complete, skill set. So yes, th this is all about. Okay, so these are the four modules. Now, every module contains some kind of, exercise that you need to go up. So once you enroll into this course, you need to firstly go through all the videos, then you have to, complete up all the exercises and everything. Okay, and yes, for this course, you need some kind of lab setup, like you require a computer with a 4 to 8 GB RAM, some kind of 20 GB of storage, some kind of, stable internet connection, and at last, a zeal to learn. Okay, some kind of resources that I'll be sharing up you guys with this course. The first thing is that we'll be giving up is the videos, the video content and the audio content and whatever notes can. Secondly, you will get a kind of OSINT report template that you can use for crafting up your open source intelligence reports. Secondly, you will get some kind of plugin links, okay, for the Chrome and Mozilla so that you can set up your own browser-based OSINT machine. Secondly, you will be getting up a kind of VM machine, okay. In that, you can just start your investigations related to open source. Moving to the next part, you will be getting some kind of tools and idea and demonstration of all the tools that can be helpful, whether it is a a GitHub-based tool, whether it is a command line tool, whether it is a Windows tool. That tool will help you. Okay. Secondly, you will be getting up some kind of OPSEC tools list, okay, for operational security, for maintaining your digital footprints over the internet. You will be getting up some kind of tools that will help you for sure. Secondly, at last, but last but not the least, you will be getting up a list of all the bookmarks that you can use for different kind of OSINT purposes, whether it is people search, whether it is a, area monitoring, geo intelligence, special intelligence, whatever it is. So yes, that's the brief about this course, and we hope you definitely like this course from my side. And at last, what you have to do is you have to do a MCQ test. Okay, so once the material, whatever is included, whether it is a text-based data, whether it is a questions, okay, whether it is like video content, whatever it is, once you complete the complete data, once you complete the whole structure, okay, all the materials, exercises, labs, everything, then you will be entitled to get a course, a certification. That is yes, okay. So that you need to do, and yes, there will be a like forum support. So there will be a forum. So once you enroll into this, you are already enrolled into the forum, And yes, you can ask your questions and the team will be there to help you out, and I'll be also there to help you out. So yes, this is all about this course. That is OSINT Fundamentals, and that is an introduction to OSINT. Thank you.